theta goes beyond 90 degree, your diagram will become like this. Is it okay? Again, you take any point here, you measure the angle, that will give you 120 degree. You take any point on this, you measure with the base z axis, that will give you the 120 degree. Is it okay, sir? The angle between this line and this line is 120 degree. Say this is your plus z axis. This is the surface, your newly formed cone. You take any point here, you measure the angle. Definitely that will be what? 120 degree. Even if this is this side also, you can take any point, you measure the angle. That will be 120 degree. What happens? Your cone is getting inverted. It's going in the other way. Okay. If you increase theta, when it is 90 degree, it is on the base plane. When it is more than 90 degree, it comes downward side. It comes downward side. Okay. It was in upward side. Now it comes to downward side. Again, always that axis of the cone is here only at the center point. Okay. Yes. Now, say this is again. Please note down. Please note down in your notes also. This is theta is equal to say something around 45 degree. This can be something around 60 degree. Now I am going to draw a cone with the theta of 120 degree. I am not saying this is exactly 120 degree, but if it is a 120 degree, what will happen? Similar to that. 120 degree. Okay. Yeah, please wait a bit. Yeah, first of all, I will clear the existing diagram. A little bit problem is there. Then. Okay, now once my theta increases, my diagram will look like this, sir. Okay, my diagram will go like this. This is anyway my x, this is my y, this is my z. Please note down very clearly what I told. What is theta? Theta is always angle measurement from the z axis. What is theta? Theta is always angle measurement from the z axis. Please note down. See, this is the cone surface. Okay, this is the cone surface. Okay, what is the angle? 120 degree. Even if you take here, what is the angle? That is 120 degree. Where you can take anywhere point. You can take any point here. You measure the angle with the z axis, positive z axis. That is 120 degree. That is 120 degree. Okay. And again, you can do one more thing. You can you rotate the diagram. You rotate because you can take anywhere. You can take the point anywhere on this surface. You rotate anywhere. And again, you take a point there, okay? You take the point from here to here. Definitely, that will be 120 degree. Please, you have to imagine yourself what is actually happening. 120 degree means, ninga paper la paakkuradhu mattume paathina irukkudadhu. Inside rotationally, adhu 120 degree irukkana artham. Okay, even in the rotation, lateral surface area, that is in a rotation format. Engirundhu choose pannalum ungalukku enna varum? 120 degree. Is it okay, sir? How theta is getting varied? Initially, my theta was like this. As I increase, it is going like this. It is going like this. then it is become like this, then it goes like this, okay, like this, it keeps on going. Yes, what will happen if theta is equal to 180 degree? Anybody say? I will clear this. Say this is my theta is equal to 120 degree. If my theta goes closer to 180 degree, how will be the structure? Anybody, can anybody explain this?
Straight line, sir. Theta axis lo ore line, sir. Theta axis.
Yes. Yes. What about others? Can you draw the diagram, madam? Very close to that. Say if it is very near 170 degree like that.
That's right.
Increases more. Okay, that is exactly theta is equal to 180 degree. If it is closer, then it will be very small. Okay. If it is around 170 degree, again it will be like this. Okay. Yes, madam, it's correct. Okay. Are you all satisfied with this? With this explanation, how theta varies? Oh, okay. Oh, actually, theta varies. Yes. Next. Anyway. So again, you know what is R. You know what is theta. You know what is phi. Phi we have already discussed in cylindrical coordinate system. There is nothing new here. Same thing. Now what I am going to do? I am going to intersect this R with theta. Now I know what is R. I know what is theta. Now I am going to intersect these two. Yes, please somebody tell me what I will get intersection of these two things. Please, if you are not talking, you switch off your mic. Yes, everyone. Everyone, please check your mic. Check your mic. If you are not talking, please switch off the mic. Okay. Now I know what is R, what is theta, what is phi. Now I am going to intersect this R with the theta. R is equal to constant. Phi is equal to theta is equal to constant. I will try to intersect these two. What shape it comes? What shape it comes? Okay. For that, I will take a theta in the positive manner here. Then it will be easy to understand and visualize. So I will bring the cone upward. By choosing theta in such a way, it is below 90 degree. Once if I choose a theta below 90 degree, my cone will become here. Okay. Oh, so I will clear here. Clear. So first I will make a sphere. I made some sphere. Now I will make a cone. I'll make a cone. I can take any radius. Okay. Now, clearly it is visible that red color is. So for that, I am using this option, intersection of two surfaces. Please wait. That function is not working, I think. Wait a bit. Anyway, that is a circle. But again, to visualize that also, here one option is there, intersection of two surfaces. I am taking one surface. I am taking another surface, and again, is there any change there? But nothing is there. But please imagine, please look here. Definitely, that is a circle. See that half portion of the circle is visible here, and remaining thing is will be available inside. Definitely, it will form what, sir? Circle. Definitely, it will form a circle. Okay. This will be making a circle like this. Okay, that half of the portion will be on another side. Okay. Next, please, what will happen if I increase? Now, I got some circle. Okay, I got some circle by intersecting cone with the sphere. If I increase theta value, still I will get some circle. Whether the circle will be bigger than the existing one or smaller?
Smaller, sir.
Please be careful. I am going to increase theta. See, now I am. Okay. This is my theta.
Increase,
now I am going
sir,
to increase.
Increase.
Yes. What about
bigger,
others? Once if I increase theta here. Because I am in this stage, not below this one, okay, below the base plane. I am above the base plane. Once if I increase theta, theta is what, sir? You draw the line like this, you measure the angle, that is the theta. If I increase theta, what will happen? It goes like this. So once if I increase theta, my circle also will increase. So please, please see here. So I can choose a circle here. I can choose a circle. Okay, anywhere like this, I can choose anywhere. Are you understanding, sir? By varying theta, I can choose any circle on the sphere. Is it okay, sir?
Okay.
By varying theta, I can choose any circle on this sphere, concentric circles. Again, given a circle. Say, suppose I have chosen this circle by fixing some theta. I have fixed theta. Already I fixed R. And again, I fixed theta. I have chosen some circle. Now, in this circle, I can go anywhere on this circle. That will be decided by what, sir? That will be decided by pi. Okay? So, at this stage, what we are aiming? The intersection of these two surfaces is giving you the circle. The circle is falling on the which plane, sir? Horizontal plane or vertical plane? That also they will confuse. It is giving you the circle. It is in horizontal plane or vertical plane? Yeah, please tell that is a horizontal plane. XY plane is always a horizontal plane for us. For a practical purpose, XY plane is always what, sir? Horizontal plane. Okay, it is in a horizontal plane. The circle is lying on the horizontal plane. Okay. Or otherwise, the circle formed is parallel to the horizontal plane, parallel to the XY plane. Okay. Please be remember about that. Okay. Then I will take another case. Okay. First one is R, theta, phi. Now we have collapsed R with theta. Now what I am going to do? I will collapse theta with the phi. I will collapse theta with a pi. Okay. So, for that I have to delete this R. Already some theta is there. Please. Now, I have to form a pi. Yes, sir. For simplicity, pi I can take anything. 0 degree or 90 degree. Which I can take, sir? Somebody tell me. I cannot take middle value. 45 degree also I can take, but we cannot guarantee that it is actually 45 or like that. Okay, I can take pi value, anything 0 or 45 or 90 degree. Okay, for simplicity, I will take, yes, 90 degree. Pi is 90 degree. You can take any value of pi. Once if I take pi is equal to 90 degree, pi is equal to 90 degree is a plane. Again, that pi plane is always, yeah, which plane? Perpendicular plane. That is always, yeah, perpendicular to the base plane. Yes, perpendicular planes. Okay, so I will choose that. Okay, so now I have taken pi is equal to 90 degree plane. But please note down, here we will get one more plane. Please don't concentrate about that. Because if you choose pi is equal to 90 degree plane, you will get a one more plane, 270 degree. Because in this half, we cannot create a semi-infinite plane. It will give you the complete infinite plane. But your concentration has to be here. This is your pi is equal to 90 degree plane. Okay. Now, somebody please tell me, I will rotate this diagram a little bit. Then it will be clear. See. Yes, okay, something like this. Okay, now your plane is intersecting the cone. What is the answer you are getting, sir? Is it a vertical line or slanted line or a horizontal line or a circle?
Vertical line.
Horizontal line.
Vertical, completely vertical. Horizontal, completely horizontal. In this case.
Slant.
Yeah, that's why that function is not working. Otherwise, it will be very, very clear. The intersection of these two surfaces. Again, you are not using your imagination. That's the main problem. See, this cone means this is not a solid cone, sir. This is a hollow cone. Please remember. Because we have to concentrate on surface only. We should not concentrate what is inside the surface. That's why you are making a mistake, I think. Our aim is always to form a surface, not a volume. Okay? You have to concentrate only on the surface, not inside the surface. Okay, anyway.
Ramp line madri varuma sir.
Yes, ramp. Are you getting that point? Dotted lines. This is what we are interested, sir. This is the intersection. Simply a ramp line. Again, you will get one more line, but we are not interested in that. Okay, because this is our plane. Okay, this is only our plane. We are interested in this. So what you are getting? You are getting some ramp line, some slanted line. So please. Please somebody tell me, then by changing pi, already cone is there, by changing pi, can I choose any line like this? See, I can choose this line or I can choose this line, any line under the surface. Yes, sir? I can choose any slanted line on the lateral surface of the cone by varying what, sir? Already cone is there and pi is in my hand. By changing the value of the pi, I can choose any slanted line on the cone, any slanted, because pi is having flexibility over 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi. So I can choose any slanted line on this cone, Yes, sir, that is the idea. Okay. So like this. So in this case, here you are getting this value. Once by changing the value, you can get any slanted line on the lateral surface of this cone. You can choose line, okay? You can choose this line also, but what you have to do accordingly, you have to choose that. You can choose this line also, you can choose. Accordingly, you have to choose your pi. Once if you change the pi, the plane will change, the intersection will change. You will get a corresponding slanted line, okay? So what is happening? The intersection of these two things, cone with pi plane, you are getting a slanted line, okay? Next, what is our idea, sir? Next, what we will do? What we have to do? Anyway, r, theta, comma, pi. R and theta already compared. Theta, comma, pi compared. So, r and pi, you have to compare. R and pi. Okay? So, anyway, pi is already there. I will make r. I will delete theta. So, I delete theta. I will make r. I should have some r. Already pi is there, some pi. So r means it will give you the sphere. Okay. Again, take care. And it is clear. Yes, are you getting? See, R is equal to constant is a some kind of sphere. Okay, and again, pi is equal to constant is another plane. The intersection of these two things is, you are getting what, sir? Line or circle or half circle or full circle? Half circle or full circle? What we needed actually?
Half circle, sir.
Yeah, half circle is correct because this is theta is equal to 90 degree. Theta is equal to 270 degree also will be there. We are not interested in this. Okay, in this half we cannot ignore that. Okay, it comes in parallel with the semi-infinite plane. Anyway, that is not interested. Okay, theta is equal to 90 degree is our interest. Okay, so our answer is this one only. Our answer is this one only. See, please imagine how the curve is like a semi-circular line. Semi-circular line. This is a line, semi-circular line, not a full circle. Semi-circular line. You will get a semi-circular line. That is the idea. That is the idea. Okay. Once when they are writing this in the textbook, using entire semicircle line, only you can see what, sir? Only half portion of the semicircle line. See, in your textbook, you go and see, they will give you this half portion only because bottom portion you cannot see in a 2D diagram. Okay, in a bottom portion you cannot see. Okay, anyway, we'll go to our material, then we'll visualize that. Okay, are you getting that concept? So what is the idea here? What is the idea? Say I can take, please wait. See here, what is the idea? I can take any sphere. I can go anywhere on the sphere by what means? Like this. I can go, my theta is 0 degree, it may be like this. If it is increasing, it will go like this. If my theta is 90 degree, it will be like this. If it is more than 90 degree, it will be going in the another way. Okay. Like this, I can go anywhere on the sphere. Like, see, this is a semicircular line. This is a semicircular line. That line can be, please wait. Okay, sir. This is a semicircular line. You can have a control over that line. See, you can choose a line like this also. Like this also you can choose a line. Like this also you can choose a line. But what will vary, sir? Pi will vary. Okay. Pi will vary. You can choose anywhere. You can choose any circular line. But what will vary? Which line you are choosing? That will be decided your pi. That will decide pi. Okay. Semicircular line. You can take any semicircular line on the sphere by varying pi. By varying pi. If your pi is zero, that semicircular line will fall on which one, sir? See, somebody please tell me answer. If your pi is zero, your semicircular line will fall in which plane? This is x, this is y, this is z. If your pi is zero,
x is the plane.
Yeah, your semicircular line will fall on x, z plane. If your pi is 90 degree, so it will fall on y, z plane. If your pi is 180 degree, it will fall on minus x, z plane. Okay, like this, it goes on. If your pi is 270 degree, it falls on minus y and z degree, z axis. Okay. Okay, like this. Okay. By varying your pi, that is the idea, sir. So, different surface. Different surfaces. Okay. Okay. We are having three different surfaces. Okay. Again, sorry. We have formed three different surfaces by intersecting separately. Okay. R and theta and theta and pi and R and pi. Okay. Then finally, we will have aim is to get a particular point. To get a particular point. Anyway, what is in our hand? See, what is our final aim? To fix all the value r, theta and phi. Once you intersect all these things, you will get a point. You will get a point. Anyway, what we are already having? Okay. So r we are having, phi we are having. We have to bring theta here, then finally what we will get? We will get a point. We will get a point. Okay. Now let's draw theta is equal to something. Theta is equal to something is what, sir? Cone. Theta is equal to something is a cone. That cone may be in the above top plane or in the, it may be in the bottom plane. If theta is between okay, now I will choose theta in between 0 to 90 degree. Okay, let's see. Somebody tell me, if I want to get a point here, if I want to get a point here, what I have to do, which parameter I have to change?
Theta.
Theta has to be increased or decreased?
Increase.
Yes, theta has to be increased. Theta has to be increased. Okay. Okay. That is the understanding. Theta has to be increased. Okay. Or otherwise, please tell me, I am already here. If I want to have a point, say here, what I have to change? Which parameter I have to change? Say I want a point here.
R
and anything else? Yes, in R only actually we have to put here because that surface comes here. What I have to change? I have to change R. So இது போல நீங்க இமேஜின் பண்ணி பாருங்க நம்மளுடைய எய்ம் பாயிண்ட் அச்சீவ் பண்றது அதுக்கு நம்ம என்ன பண்றோம் அப்படின்னு எல்லாத்தையும் பார்க்கணும். ஓகே, இதுதான் வந்து ஸ்பெரிக்கல் கோஆர்டினேட்ஸ் பேசிக்ஸ். டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் சர்ஃபேஸ் எப்படி ஃபார்ம் ஆகுது, இன்டர்செக்ஷன் ஆஃப் சர்ஃபேஸ் வந்து எப்படி லைன்ஸாக வருது, என்ன மாதிரியான லைன்ஸ் வருது, அகைன் இன்டர்செக்ஷன் ஆஃப் ஆல் த சர்ஃபேசஸ் ஆல் த்ரீ பாசிபிள் சர்ஃபேசஸ் வில் கிவ் யூ த பாயிண்ட் ஆல் பாசிபிள் சர்ஃபேசஸ் வில் கிவ் யூ த பாயிண்ட் அண்ட் அகைன் ஃபைனலி ஐ எம் ஆஸ்கிங் ஒன் மோர் க்வெஸ்டின் ப்ளீஸ் ரீகால் What is the range of R, sir? 0 to
infinity.
Infinity. What is the range of theta?
0 to pi.
0 to pi, 180 degree. What is the range of pi? 0 to 2 pi. Please be clear about this. 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi. Okay. This is the idea. Now, I'm going to trying to explain what is the relation between this system with the regular coordinate system, rectangular coordinate system. So what I am going to do, r comma theta comma pi, I am going to relate with what? X, y, z. Okay, x, y, z. In spherical also we have did. So similarly, in cylinder also we have done that. So similarly, here in spherical system also, I am going to relate r comma theta comma pi with x, y, z. See, please be careful. This is little bit tricky. Okay, so still I will try to explain this. Okay, the relations. Okay, so again, what do you mean by these relations, sir? Say I have chosen some point. I will clear this. Say I have chosen some point. For this, definitely there will be some r, there will be some theta, there will be some pi. Is it okay, sir? Yes. This is r comma theta comma pi with some r, with some theta, with some pi. I have reached that point, red color point. Is it the only way to reach that point? I can also reach in this way, no? X, Y, Z by fixing some X and Y, corresponding X, Y, Z value. Still, I can reach that point. Okay? With the help of X, Y, Z also, I can reach the point because that is the basic coordinate system, rectangular coordinate system. Okay? And again, this is not the only way. With the help of this thing also, I can reach. With the help of rho and pi and with Z also, I can reach that point. Okay? Now, what is the interrelation between these things? That... we'll look into now. Okay, that we will see now. What is the interrelations of these parameters? Okay, what is x? How x is related with this parameters? How x is related with this parameter? Okay. Okay. Please wait. Anyway, this is our. For that, I will take some different angle. Then it will be instead of theta is equal to 90. Instead of phi is equal to 90 degree, I will take phi is equal to 45 degree. Then only the diagram will be little bit clear to you. Okay. So now I will modify my pi to 45 degree. Okay, first we'll delete that plane. Now I have to okay. Please wait a bit. Yes, okay. Now it's okay, I think. Okay. Now what is the common point, sir? Anybody? Can anybody denote that common point? Yeah. Hmm? Yes. Can anybody denote the common point here? See, this is my point. This is my point. So I am having some r, some theta, some pi. Okay, I am having some r, some theta, some pi. Anyway, you know this is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis. Okay, and you all know what is the angle of this one? Theta. Angle of that particular point. Okay, angle of that particular point from z axis is theta. Okay, then if it is theta, then what will be the z value? If it is theta, what will be the z value? Anybody? And again, the distance of that point from the origin is r. If it is r, again that this x z axis value will be r cos theta. Is it equal to what, sir? R cos theta. Is it okay? I have chosen a point. That point is theta degree angle from the z axis. If it is from theta degree, my z axis value will be r cos theta. You apply the Pythagoras theorem and everything. Cos theta is equal to what, sir? Adjacent side by something like that you apply. So if it is r, so z axis value will be r cos theta. Okay, z axis will be r cos theta. So the corresponding value for this value will be r cos theta. Now anybody tell me what will be the value in the y axis? Yes.
R sin theta.
R sin theta. Okay. Yeah, it is R sin theta. Yes, okay. It is R sin theta. Yes, it is correct. So now you please imagine yourself. Please. Yeah, he has given correct answer. That is R sin theta. This is R sin theta. Anyway, I will delete everything. See, I have chosen a point here. Okay. From this, this is the point. If this is theta, okay, this is at angle of, this is with the radius of r. definitely this value is r cos theta, and this value is r sin theta. Please somebody tell me, if I project this point to the base plane, if I project this point to the base plane, what will be that value, sir? I am projecting this point to the base plane. What will be this value? Anybody? That is also r sin theta. Once if I project that point, like top view, sir, if you make a top view, if that point goes to the base plane, okay? Here, if it is here, again, the distance will be whatever the distance you had here, say r sin theta, the same distance will be available here, r sin theta only, okay? R sin theta only. And again, you know that this particular point will be definitely with what angle, sir? With what angle? With the pi angle. It will be at pi 90. Angle. Once if it is at pi angle, yes, sir?
90 degrees.
What is the angle? Not 90 degrees, sir. Pi, I have taken something. No, sir. Pi, I have taken something like 45 degree like that. Okay. Once if you project that point, it will be in the base plane. Even if it is in the base plane, I am taking it as a pi itself, some angle. I have taken around 45 degree in this case. Say it is some angle of pi. Okay. Once if it is pi, what will be this value? Already r sin theta is in your hand. And one more angle comes, pi. So r sin theta cos pi. What is this value? R sin theta cos pi. R sin theta cos pi. And once, if you extend this to x axis, that will be r sin theta.